Medical Tourism Corporation interview with Dr. Gautam Alabadia. Dr. Alabadia is an infertility expert in India and vice president of the World Association of Reproductive Medicine. In addition to being the director of the Rotunda Fertility Clinic in India, he is a visiting lecturer at Tel Aviv University, Israel, and has published more than 100 papers and several textbooks in the field of human reproduction.
I'm Dr. Alabadia. I'm a practicing fertility physician in the city of Bombay, practicing since 1990. And I'm the vice president of the World Association of Reproductive Medicine. I'm the only Indian to be appointed as visiting faculty to the University of Tel Aviv Sackler School of Medicine. Recently, the government of India has appointed me on the experts committee to draft the ART guidelines for practicing assisted reproduction in India. And I have, to my credit, over 100 published papers in peer-reviewed journals. And my field of interest is third-party reproduction and embryo transfer. I have, in fact, written edited a monogram on embryo transfer, which is sold all over the world. And we have actually all our expertise and the team now is our focus is dedicated to third party reproduction, including donor egg IVF and gestational surrogacy. We are the only clinic in India, Rotunda, which is an LGBT friendly clinic. So we offer treatment to lesbians, gays, same sex couples as per the drafted Indian guidelines. We have a large surrogacy program which is run according to within the purview of the ICMR guidelines. That means we can offer surrogacy to a heterosexual couple, to a woman who would otherwise have not achieved her pregnancy or carried her pregnancy to term due to some medical condition or some serious debilitating medical condition or post-surgical condition. So this will include women, commonly the indications of women born without a uterus, women who have undergone removal of the uterus or hysterectomy due to some problems in childbirth or due to malignancy. We have women who have severe arthritis or some other severe debilitating medical condition, which metabolic condition, which does not allow them to carry a pregnancy to term. So for all these patients, we ask their physician to provide a certificate that says that they would otherwise never have got pregnant and gestational surrogacy is the only way forward. Once we get a certificate like this, then we offer these heterosexual couples surrogacy. The other large group, equally large group, is same-sex couples. Homosexual couples who would never have otherwise achieved their own genetic children without the help of gestational surrogacy. The third group of patients also, which is now becoming larger, is single men. Single men, single fathers, our ICMR draft guidelines allow us to treat single fathers with gestational surrogacy, offer them gestational surrogacy. And today we have treated successfully patients from over 19 countries. We have been covered by almost 7 different national TV channels, including Denmark, Sweden. There's some channel in USA at Christmas. They are going to premiere a documentary called Made in India, where they followed a US couple from the US and their journey here. When they took back their babies from gestational surrogacy. So we've got good press and we are now known a lot of it by word of mouth and with our reputation that we are now leaders in the field in gestational surrogacy in India. There are always voices of protest for anything new that starts in. When IVF started in 1978, Patrick Steptoe and Robert Edwards were castigated and people said the same. They had even the frontline newspapers telling them that what they are doing is absolutely unethical. Today, you know, 30 years down the line, it's absolutely normal to, IVF is considered normal, even a kindergarten, you know, even a school child knows what is IVF. Similarly, I feel that gestational surrogacy has been unnecessarily hyped by media. It was always there from early 1981-82, this service has been offered. It's just that now it's getting politicized that, you know, foreigners should not be allowed surrogacy in India and by some women's organizations and NGOs. Otherwise, what we are doing is absolutely legal and within the purviews of the guidelines laid down by the Indian government. And I feel that it's a win-win situation for all. Somebody who doesn't have a uterus or a gay couple who would otherwise never have been able to complete their family get a chance to complete their family. And the surrogate who comes from a weaker economic background gets the money to pay for a children's education or buy a new house or, you know, move to a better life. So I feel that it's absolutely, you're actually helping two families to progress. I don't think it's unethical. The other programs are now benchmarking themselves with our, you know, success rates. Annually, we turn out about a success rate of 50% when we consider absolutely IVF, sometimes from 38 and 39 year olds who women who want to get surrogacy done. And with young donors, with healthy young donors, we have a 60% pregnancy rate. Last 6 months data, and in certain months we've gone up to 72% pregnancy rates, to as low as 38% when you have older women coming and you have to do surrogacy for them. So I think on an average you should take 50% as a benchmark figure, and that is what we counsel our patients with when they come. See, I have no competition with somebody who wants to charge less. We know that, you know, we were the first people to have organized a separate hostel for these surrogates. We have our own nutritionist going there. We have our own nurses going there every day taking care of the pregnant surrogates. It's a voluntary program. We don't confine them forcefully. But right in the beginning, there are surrogates who agree to get roomed in with their children into our hostel. And some surrogates who have family compulsions stay with them. We have a dedicated software to give updates to the parents. The ultrasound reports are sent in. We have a dedicated team of 5 people only managing the surrogacy aspect of assisted reproduction in the clinic. We don't cut corners. So I feel that we have absolutely, these are, you know, you have all sorts of clinics, and we have positioned ourselves as a premium clinic with no nonsense. We have, you know, we work 365, 24/7, and we have 2 senior doctors always on call. You could call them in the middle of the night and they would reply. I think it's not overnight that we have achieved this reputation. It has been, you know, from 2005 when surrogacy was opened up for a myriad of indications and for out-of-town patients, out-of-country patients. We were the first ones to set standards, and I feel that we are continuously moving to give some value adds to the program. And I have been asked this a lot of times, that okay, this clinic is 20% cheaper than your clinic. I tell them, when somebody asks me second time, I say please try them out. Just even try there, you know, interacting with them, and you will know that, because the parents are going to be in another continent miles away, and their child is going to be growing in another womb in India. They need interaction. Today we were the first ones to start a tie-up with DHL called the Rotunda DHL Cryoship Program, where clients could send in their frozen gametes or frozen embryos from USA to India. We are also now starting the Skype Surrogate Connect program, where every month we'll get the surrogate so that she can talk to the intended parents, genetic parents in the States. So we'll connect them through Skype video conferencing, and at least they'll have an idea of how well the pregnancy is growing and how well the surrogate is looked after. So these are things that we have been adding. Every 6 months we try to add something more to the program to make it, you know, where it is. today we are, you know, I think we have got now inquiries this year for surrogacy from 30 countries. And the only hitch is that we have, according to the new government guidelines, before you initiate surrogacy, the parents have to give an affidavit saying they have talked to their respective consulate and it is their responsibility for taking the baby back to their respective country. So many of our inquiries are from countries like Spain, Portugal, etc., where they are still battling their own consulates to find a solution of how to get the passport for the newborn baby or babies. So I feel, yes, you know, once all these get sorted out, we will be, I think, a very well-known brand and a clinic all across the globe. Surrogacy is a combined decision of husband and wife, and they sign a contract with the intended parents. Everything is put on paper. There is a schedule of payments which is also outlined. And everything is, there is nothing hidden. And we've now done, I think, from 2005 to present, we must have had over 30 deliveries, and we've had not a single problem, medical or medico-legal. The program is obviously growing, and these surrogates are now, few of them who volunteered in 2005 are now coming back for a second time around to volunteer their services. So I feel that only if the program was above board and fair and growing would surrogates come back a second time for volunteering their wombs. I remember the slogan coined by our tourism ministry a couple of years back at a big medical tourism conference in India, which said that the facilities here, there are Western trained doctors, all English speaking doctors, and I liked the slogan that said that first world treatment at third world prices. Price is a large constraint for many couples in the West, both in North America and Europe. In North America, a surrogacy cycle can set you back by $100,000 or $150,000. And in India, the price would be between $25,000 to $30,000, depending on which hotels you stay in and how you travel, etc. So even with your travel and stay, coming to India twice, you would spend, you know, maximum about $30,000 for your cycle. So what you have to be careful about is that when you treat a patient from any country, it's mandatory to first ask them to take a clearance that the baby will go back home, because in certain countries like Portugal, surrogacy is illegal and a child born out of surrogacy is not recognized by the state. So it's going to be a big problem if those problems are not sorted out before we start the internet. Another aspect is that Indian surrogate mothers are generally, by guidelines or by the proposed law, they have to be married women above the age of 21. And most of our surrogates have children of their own previously. In India, it's almost unheard of for a middle class woman, a lower middle class socioeconomic strata woman to be drinking or smoking. A lot of our Western clients have tried or investigated the Eastern European programs and then come back to India. Medico-legal problems or litigation is almost unheard of. This is not a litigious society at all.
Medical Tourism Corporation facilitates affordable medical treatment at world-class international hospitals. Fill out the estimate request form on our site for a free quote and more information.